What safety procedures are conducted, taken, during a PRP treatment? I am afraid of risks. Is the blood tested beforehand for any diseases or infections the patient might have before it is injected into the face? What if the blood is not good, and then it is injected into the face through a microneedling treatment? Couldn't this harm someone and cause bad blood to now be in their face? I want to do this, but I'm afraid of any side effects.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a question without a photo, and you're stating in your question, or you're asking, inquiring about the safety precautions that are used when using PRP, and that you have a concern about the quality of the blood as well as potential infection and whether or not that can potentially harm after undergoing a microneedling process. Well, I can certainly help you understand a little bit of the process, and I think that the question in spirit is important. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. PRP and its numerous uses is a very big part of my practice. I use it for everything from under-eye dark circles to acne scars to fine lines and wrinkles. I use it with microneedling, and I also have actually developed a hair loss treatment that combines PRP with extracellular matrix to treat male and female pattern hair loss for patients who come to us from all over the world. So, as far as the question about infection and the quality of the blood, well, the blood is yours, and therefore, if you're healthy, then it is likely that you will have no untoward effects from your own blood. And it's taken at the same time that you are going to have the treatment. So it's not like it's banked or stored. It's drawn, it's processed, and then it is used as is appropriate. Now, I think you do ask a very important question that you may not have appreciated, but I would say that it is very important to expect a high level of sterile process throughout the whole process of having your blood drawn and then spun and then placed. What I mean to say is when you go to any place that is offering PRP, and PRP has become very, very popular, and it has tremendous wide range of uses, and we use in our practice a lot, as I mentioned earlier. We in our facility, our office, we are approved by a certifying body called the Joint Commission. I'm a cosmetic surgeon. I perform a wide range of surgeries in my practice. I do eyelid surgery, facelift surgery, etc. Well, the Joint Commission is the same body that certifies hospitals, and the number one standard that we have to adhere to is, our goal is to maintain patient safety. And sterility and cleanliness of the facility and the processing is critically important. As I said earlier, we do a lot of PRP in treatments. So we can have several patients getting PRP treatments all in the office at the same time. So we have a very specific process of drawing the blood, labeling the tubes, using sterile process when we place it into centrifuges, when it is withdrawn. All those things are done with the goal of never breaking sterility so that a risk of infection from a source is minimized. That's within the facility. So I think that that's important to understand. And so when you are meeting with different doctors, get a sense of what their process is like. I would say that most physicians who are in a position where they are working in a certified facility, such as a facility certified by the Joint Commission, that there is a certain discipline and standard that's being adhered to by their staff so that they maintain a certain high standard of compliance in order to maximize the safety for every patient. So I think that to ask you a question about the quality of PRP, basically for most people who are generally healthy, and even if they have other medical conditions, including diabetes and other issues, as long as they can heal from a cut, then they usually are able to have a PRP treatment. The question is where, what is the desired outcome and what is the specific indications and is it the right thing for the issues you're concerned about? So I would say meet with qualified, experienced doctors, ask about the process, get a sense of what the facility is like. I think it's very important to look for that kind of adherence and quality. And I think that you can probably feel secure about having your first treatment. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.